still too high in the sense that Fed would like to get to
a non-inflationary growth path of 2% or less. And the growth rates have come in at roughly 2.5% or better. So it's not slow enough to take the inflationary edge off.
And in a separate report, the Commerce Department says the after-tax profits of American corporations rose by 0.2% in the third quarter. Transportation and financial companies, utilities, and non-financial industries had the biggest profit gains. Linda?
Computer giant IBM and Japanese computer maker Fujitsu have apparently reached the end of the road in a dispute over Fujitsu's use of IBM software. And as New York correspondent Neil Cavuto reports, the $237 million payment IBM will receive under that settlement is far less than many in the computer industry had expected.
After six contentious years, the epic IBM Fujitsu battle was deemed finished today, not by the companies themselves, but by a pair of arbitrators brought in to settle the case.
It's rather like giving the specifications for all the holes and plugs in the back of a stereo amplifier so that you can put compatible stereo components together.
What that means is that Fujitsu will be able to obtain, under strict guidelines, access to the highly touted software that controls IBM mainframe computers. In return, IBM gets cash, about $237 million from Fujitsu, covering the future use of Fujitsu software, some of which contained IBM programming data. In addition, Fujitsu will pay a fee of up to $51.3 million next year, depending on access to IBM materials. That would bring to $833 million the amount Fujitsu will have paid for the past and future use of its programs containing IBM material. Speaking only through official statements, Fujitsu noted the, quote, resolution of these disputes fulfills Fujitsu's desire to have rivalry with IBM return to its natural and appropriate arena, the marketplace. IBM said it was, quote, pleased with the results of this arbitration. Officially, arbitrators today echoed IBM's sentiment.
This fee fairly compensates IBM.
But some on Wall Street aren't so sure, saying IBM got far less than the billion-dollar settlement many here were counting on. Still, IBM watcher Peter LeBay insists Big Blue fared well.
Fujitsu still has to do their own software development work. It's time-consuming, it's costly, etc. But Fujitsu does have the guarantee that when it completes its work, it will be compatible with IBM.
Well, doesn't that make this, in the end, a victory for IBM competitors?
I think that's an overstatement, because it would be if you were relieved from the burden of doing development work. This does not relieve you from that burden.
Despite some criticism on Wall Street that IBM might very well have given away the baby with the bathwater, a number of officials in and outside the company say that might not be the case. They insist that in the long term, IBM could prove the real strategic winner, thereby assuring that Fujitsu and other potential competitors in the mainframe market play by IBM's compatible rules. In New York, Neil Cavuto for the Nightly Business Report.
Well, there was little competition for the bulls on Wall Street today as the Dow jumped more than 20 points. With the details, here's Paul.
Today's daily report of an upward revision in third quarter, we meant to say third quarter gross national product growth from 2.2% to 2.6% was smaller than Wall Street expected. And since it was the slowest quarterly growth rate in about 2 years, recent fears that the economy was overheating subsided and buyers gained the upper hand as the New York Stock Exchange opened this morning, enabling the Dow Industrial Average to advance nearly 4 points by 10 a.m. And that's in the wake of yesterday's closing gain of 6.75 points. The upturn faded during the next hour when the broader market remained flat while volume was unimpressive. But after oil prices weakened, and the bond market reacted with a nice firming trend, stocks rebounded sharply during midday, kicking in considerable program buying activity, along with plenty of short covering purchases. By 2 p.m., the industrial average shot up to nearly a 17-point gain as the advanced decline ratio became 8-5 positive, and that was on improved volume.